lie down. Not you, your dog. That's what we're gonna work on now, is the command to lie down. And this is the visual cue, right in your dog's face, lie down. Now, why do we wanna do that? Number one, in movie making, of course, Benji spends a lot of time lying down, contemplating, so it's good to have that position done. But one of the real reasons that you want to do this is it gives you an extra level of control. You know, when you have your dog sitting and staying, that's good. That's good control. But if she's lying down and staying, it's even better, because when the dog is sitting, she's ready to pounce, ready to walk, ready to go run after something if you know, something grabs her attention. And if you get her lying down, she's a lot more apt to mind you and to just stay when she's lying down and staying. So again, the command is this, right in front of their face, lie down. And we'll bring a couple of the other dogs out to show you this, because the Australian Terriers are just learning this. And the follow-up to the lie down, which is good for two or three reasons we'll get into, is head down. Once they're lying down, is to put their head all the way down on the floor. The two reasons to do that: one, it's very, very cute and almost always gets an "aww" from your audience. Number two is that in movie making, we have to have that, because some of the greatest pictures of Benji, or you know, the work with Benji in movies, is when that head comes down into a very big close-up and the whole audience just goes, "Oh, isn't that sweet?" So we'll show you that too, because that's the way we get that, and I'll show you how it works with Benji, and then we'll pull some of the other dogs in, so we'll see ones that are not quite so well-trained as Benji is. Okay, Benji, on your feet. On your feet. Get on your feet. Good girl. Get on your feet. Wake up. Come on. Wake up. There you go. Okay, now like I was saying, what we do is we go right down in her face so that she understands, and we take the hand with the treat all the way down to the ground. Lie down. Lie down. Now, she's doing it immediately because that she understands. She knows the cue. She knows what to do. But Benji, on your feet. On your feet. Come on. Get up on your feet. Good girl. The first thing you do after you try this two or three times, if you've got the treat in your hand, you know, like between your fingers right here, when your hand goes all the way to the ground, the tendency of the dog, pop up, come on, is to want to get down to the treat. So they're very likely to lie down in order to do that. Then you praise and praise and praise and praise and give them the treat. If that doesn't work after several efforts, if they just look at you like, why is your hand down there on the ground, on your feet? On your feet, Benji. Benji, on your feet. Hello, wake up. Come on. Put the leash on and do just a little tugging on the back of their neck, because that, you know, not enough to hurt them, and you don't jerk on it, but as you give the cue, if you tug on the back of their neck, the tendency is to lie down. And we'll show you how this works with a couple of the smaller dogs as well. Then if that doesn't work, and there I have seen a few dogs where neither one of these things worked, even with a lot of time doing it, then there's one other thing that we can do. Benji, on your feet. Benji, on your feet. Good girl. All right. And that is to put your hand right back here, and as you do with the treat in this hand, so she's paying attention to that, as you do this, you just apply pressure backwards, which takes her down off of these feet. Lie down. Lie down. Very good. So one of those will work over time. Got to keep doing it. Got to keep doing it. Usually when you have the treat here and you put your hand down like this, they will go down to go with the treat, to be closer to the treat. You turn it over, give it to them, praise them a lot, and they're doing it. Okay, come on, Benji. Up, nope. Now I'm going to try to get her to do the head down so that you see. That's just an extension of the cue of lie down. Okay, lie down, lie down, lie down, lie down, look up here, okay? Now, put your head down. There you go, what a good girl. Again, she anticipates that hand movement so quickly because she's got this down so pat. On your feet, good girl, on your feet, there you go. Oh, what a girl. All right, lie down and look up here, hey. Up here, here it is, no, no. Put your head down. That's the end result. It's a little more difficult to get. Again, when you're getting her to put her head down, you put that treat right on the finger so that when you get your hand right here, there's a place that she wants to go. She wants to go to where that treat is. And the minute she does, see, if you put a little piece of a treat right in between your fingers, there it is, treat's in the hand, head down. Very good. Very good. Good girl. Then you start doing backing away slowly but surely so that you say head down. And then you can do it from way away. Head down. What a girl. Then the next thing that we do, and there's no particular reason for you to want to do this other than the fact that it's fun and it's cute, and I use this a lot when we're doing benefits and doing speaking engagements because people like it a lot. So I'll show you this. This is called on your side. Once she's down, to get on her side, back up, back up, back up, back up, go on, back up, back up, back up, no, back up, back up, back up, whoa, right there, good. Give her a place to go. Get on your feet, on your feet, on your feet. All right, lie down and on your side. On your side, get over on your side, get over on your side. Good girl, put your head down. And then you use the stay command, which you already have, and say stay, 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 stay. Good girl. All right, that's a good girl. Sit. The way that you train that is lie down, Benji. Sorry, lie down. Now, what you do is you have the treat in your hand so that you can just actually take her over. You notice that the cue that I gave her was a rollover from way back, but it's the same thing. Here's on your side, on your side. See how she just rolls over trying to get to the treat? Well, that's a good girl. That's a good girl. Okay, okay. On your side. You just roll her over. Good girl. Then as she finally begins to understand what you're doing, come on, back up. Then lie down. You can do it from a distance. On your side. Good girl. That's a good girl. And you have to work this. You know, she didn't remember, she knows what she's doing. So I'm showing it to you. We'll try some of this with some of the other dogs and see how that works. Lie down. 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 Come on. Here's the treat. Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Come on, lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Come on. Lie down. Lie down. There's a lie down. And when worse comes to worse, get your face down there as well as your treat, and she will lie down, you see. Okay, on your feet. Come on. There you go. Good girl. Okay, lie down. Here's your treat. Lie down. Come on, lie down. Come on, lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Come on, lie down. There. Lie down. Good girl. Good girl. And we want to say, lie down. Lie down. Good girl. That's a good girl. Okay, good girl. And we want to say, put your head down. Put your head down. Very good. Very good girl. As we said before, all dogs learn at different paces, and these are sisters, Pontoof and Skilo, and yet they are learning at totally different paces. Skilo is taking this a lot quicker than Pontoof is. Put your head down. Put it down. Good girl. Interesting thing about the word down is that it teaches, this is putting your head down, but it's an additional vocabulary word for getting down off the couch or getting down off a ladder or running down a hill. That she begins to understand as you separate it from the cue, lie down and head down, she begins to understand that down means this way. And you can do the same thing with up, you know, get up on your feet, stand up, that sort of thing, going the other way. And up becomes another vocabulary word that could be used to say get all the way up if you want them to walk on their feet. So again, this foundation training of getting the vocabulary words in there and then separating them out into other uses of the same word gives them conceptual understanding that gives you much better communication with your pup. This is a multiple choice question, so I'm going to refer to the notes on the question. When your dog is reluctant to come to you, when something has happened, it's made him afraid or something, and you need to get him to come to you right now, which of the following is true? Chase him, stand your ground and keep calling him firmly until he comes, sit quietly and ignore him until he comes to you, lie down on the ground or squat down on the ground, getting your head as close to eye level as you can with the dog and call him, or offer him food. Which of those five do you believe is true? When your pup is reluctant to come to you, you know, probably something weird has happened. You've caught him tearing up the newspaper in the middle of the living room, and you screamed at him, and oh my gosh, now he's freaked out and he's running from you. Or something has happened that's freaked him out a little bit so that he's not wanting to come to you. You want him to come, and you want to be able to make him come to you very, very quickly. I use the example of if the dog is running out towards the street and there's traffic in the street and cars coming and you want to stop him cold and get him to come to you and he's afraid because something has happened or a car horn is screamed at him or something, you know, you want to be able to make this happen as quickly as possible. You can chase him all day long and you're never going to catch your dog, particularly if you're outside. You know, you might be able to catch him if you're inside and you finally get him cornered somewhere, but you don't want to do that because that may be the last time that you ever catch him because now he's really afraid of you coming at him. Offering him food when he's upset is not going to get him to come. What you really want to do is get down on his eye level. It's amazing. I mean, if you're in the middle of the street or out on the yard somewhere, you drop to the ground, get down as low as you can, and it's amazing how that changes your dog because suddenly he says, whoa, what's this weird thing that he's doing? And it also gets you down on his eye level so it's more friendly. And get down on your knees, get down on your belly if you have to and say, come on, come on, come on. I have seen dogs who are running flat out away and I yell at them to get their attention, drop to the ground and say, come on, come on, come on, come on. Now they're no longer afraid to come because you're not towering over them like some sort of a giant, you know, waiting to, you know, to turn them into, you know, a ball of something. You know, they just, it changes their whole attitude. So give it a try. You know, the next time you call your dog and he doesn't want to come, do that. Just drop to the ground and then call him sweetly, nicely, come on, come on, and watch what happens.